For this tutorial, I'm going to be using Eclipse Juno. And going to go to the Eclipse Marketplace. And look for Glassfish. Under application server, I'm gonna pick up this one, Glassfish Tools for Juno. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and create a new web project that I'm gonna call WebSocket Project 01. It's gonna be running on Glassfish 4. And I downloaded Glassfish 4 and unzipped it. So I'm gonna put this directory as a Glassfish server directory and as GRE gonna use so I have my JDK 1.7 under here. The program files Java. I'm gonna pick this up. JDK. Now here, gonna go ahead and create a new class. I'm gonna call server endpoint demo, and that I'm gonna put in this package. And I'm gonna annotate it as a server endpoint that I'm gonna be accessing as a project name and then slash server endpoint demo. And here I'm gonna have four methods. A handle open and a handle close. Handle error and a handle message. So essentially, I'm going to be opening a connection to the client and then exchanging messages with that client and then closing the connection. And in case of errors, there is this method, that the handle error method. So I'm gonna annotate the handle open method with the onOpen. the handle close with the onClose annotation, and the handle error with the onError annotation, and the handle message with the onMessage. So the handle open is gonna be called once when the connection is created, is established. So I'm gonna say client is now connected, and the handle close is called when a disconnect happened. I'm gonna say client is now disconnected, and for the error I'm just gonna print out the stack trace. Now for handling the message coming from the client, I'm gonna start by printing out that message. So I'm gonna say receive from client, and that's gonna be the message. And my reply to the client is gonna be that message that I received plus adding echo to it. So echo and the message. And I'll just print out what I'm gonna be sending to the client. And gonna be returning that reply message. Next, let me go ahead and create the client HTML page. I call it default.html. And the title is going to be WebSocket Tutorial 01. Now, here in the body, gonna have a text field and a button that when clicked, I'm gonna call a JavaScript function send message, and I'm also gonna have a text area where I'm gonna be displaying the interaction between this client and the server. And I'll put my JavaScript code here. And the first thing I'm gonna do when this page is up is to connect to the WebSocket server. I'm gonna do a new WebSocket, and gonna be here. So I'm localhost 8080. And the project name is WebSocket, actually project 01, and server endpoint demo that I specified here. And like the Java code on the server side, I'm gonna need four methods here in the JavaScript. I'm gonna need a process open method, and this method is gonna be called if a connection is created with a server. So the on open event is fired, and so when this happens, the process open method is called. And let me pick up this message text area here. And I'm gonna be displaying in that text area server connect, and going to a new line. Next, I'm gonna be handling connection closing events. So the on close events in process close method. And here I'm gonna be adding this message server disconnect to the text area. And let me also send a message to the server telling it that the client is disconnected now. So client disconnected message. And in case there is an error event, so on error event, I'm gonna be handling it in the process error method. And essentially all what I'm gonna have in this method is a addition of error message to the text area. And let me also add this send message method that is gonna be called when that button is clicked. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it here. So here I'm gonna be picking up what the user entered in the text in the text field, and gonna go ahead and send it to the server, and I'll add this text message that was sent to the server in the text area, in the messages text area. And let me go ahead and clear out the text message text field after the message is sent. I'm gonna set the value to empty. Now in case the user entered the close in this text field, I want to close the connection. So what I wanna do here is to check if it's different than close with the user entered. Then I'm gonna go ahead and send the message. Otherwise I'm gonna go ahead and close the WebSocket connection. When the server sends a message, gonna have an on message event, and I'm gonna be handling that event in the process message method. And in that method, all what I'm gonna have is printing out what was received from the server to the messages text area. Next, let me go ahead and run it. Open up the servers view also. Okay, I don't think it's gonna work on the internal server. So let me open up Chrome, and it works on Chrome. Copy Okay, so it connected the server. I have the server connect message here coming from process open. Let me send a message. So test 1 2 3, and so send to server is test 1 2 3, and receive from server is the test 1 2 3 added to it the echo. And on the server side, I have I received from the client test 1 2 3, and I sent back echo test 1 2 3. Let's try another one. Test 456, same thing, send to server and receive from server, and receive from client and send to client. Let me try to close the connection. If I do close, so server disconnect, and so client is now disconnected. Let me try to send some more. So test 789. So it sent it to the server, but the server didn't receive anything and it didn't reply with anything. So essentially, it's the connection is closed.